Hi, well, welcome to the Peter Bauer Therapy Center. Glad to have both Steve and Sally and your family here. My name is Roger. I'm your counselor today. So I kind of read over your files a little bit, kind of got an understanding. Steve, thank you for your service for our country. I see here that you're in the military. So just let's go ahead and just dive right in. Whose idea was it for y'all to be here today?
I think it was Sally. I don't know. She had mentioned something, but I reluctantly agreed to come. I don't even know really why we're here.
Mm-hmm. Well, yes. Well, I had spoken with a neighbor that I kind of confided on the issues that I'm having, you know, with my marriage, and she was the one that recommended that I, you know, sought out counseling. So that's how I came about to make the connection with you.
I see you also brought your children here with you as well. Sally, can you explain that part as far as having the children here? So I see we have Louise, Belle, and Luna.
Mm-hmm. That's correct. Well, definitely, you know, my kids, like I said, I feel like I'm a solo parenting. I'm married, but it's like I'm a single parent. My husband is never around. He's always gone because, you know, his job requires him to be away the majority of the time. So I'm having to deal with the brunt of all the issues, you know, with the home. Like, I have to take care of the kids. I got to make sure they go to school. I got to make sure that they go to their appointments. The kids sometimes, you know, they act, you know, in a manner that it's not good because, you know, they just becoming a little rebellious. And I'm getting concerned that, you know, the fact that he's not home able to help me is also affecting our kids.
So, Sally, it sounds like you have a lot on your plate right now, especially when your husband's deployed. Is that right?
Yes. I am very much overwhelmed. I don't have a chance to take a break. You know, like right now, I have to like rely on my neighbor as an example. If I have to go to a personal appointment for myself so that she can at least back me up and watch the kids so that I can go take care of, you know, my personal appointments, as a perfect example.
Steve, hearing Sally right now, how does that make you feel?
I mean, I hear what she's saying. It's gotta be a lot, but I mean, there's nothing I can do. She knew about this going into this marriage. I was already in when we got married. So, I mean, I don't know what the big deal is. I have the most crap I have to deal with at work that she don't have to deal with either. So I'm trying to be the best husband, the best father, the best that I can be, but there's a lot going on just inside of my head. I don't know what to do sometimes. And then just coming home is, you know, it's hard when you're deployed so often. I've been deployed 5 different times in the last 6 years. So coming home, it's just more stress. Where are you going? What are you doing? I want to relax after going through some crazy stuff. And so, I mean, is that too much to ask? You know, it's just hard all around.
So obviously it took a big step for y'all to be here today. So for both you and Steve, you and Sally, what is it that y'all would like to see different when y'all walk out of here?
Well, I definitely would like to see a little bit more cooperation, you know, when he's home at least, that, you know, can help me, you know, feel that he's also a parent and a member of this family, that I'm not flying solo here, because I feel that the burden, it's on me. Like, I get no break. And I understand his job is very difficult. I understand these deployments are very challenging. I did understood when I married him about, you know, the challenges that the military does present for family units, because, you know, there's always the chance that you're going to have to go strange places and be gone for long terms of time. But it's just that I need a little bit of time from him, you know, that we can do things as a family. I think that would also help the children, especially my little rebellious one, fall in line, you know, because like I said, it's difficult to try to manage all three of them at the same time.
So Steve, how does this make you feel hearing her wanting to kind of get you engaged in the family a little bit more? It sounds like maybe when you're at home, how can you engage more with the family?
I mean, my dad wasn't there when I was growing up, so I don't understand the big deal. You know, you kids have to learn how to grow up on their own. And I just want some more, a little bit more understanding about what I'm going through every single day as well. You know, I'm bringing home money. I'm making sure that the family survives. What else do you want? You know what I mean? It's like, you don't have to do and you know, put your life on the line possibly every single day that you're out there. You know, it's, what else do you want? It's just like, what else do I need to provide? How else do I need to be there? So it's just frustrating. I just want more understanding about what I'm going through. I don't think it's there.
Now kids, let's start with the oldest. Luis, now just from my notes from the pre-screening and what your mom just kind of mentioned, it sounds like you are having some troubles at school. Can you tell me a little bit about what's going on at school and maybe tell me how you're feeling about your parents right now?
I feel like my parents are not present in my life. They don't have their support. Sometimes I don't go to school. I hang out with my friends and they actually listen to me. They care about me and they support me. They also, you know, give me things so I could feel better. And I feel like, you know, I'm part of them. They're, you know, when I'm with them, they're my family. And when I'm at home, I feel like I'm lonely. I don't have a sense of, you know, a belonging. So my mom gets mad because I hang out with my friends. She doesn't like them. She thinks they're a bad influence, but I think they're a good friends that support me.
And how is your relationship with your parents when they're both home? Like, have you talked to them about that? How you're feeling?
No, because my mom's always busy. She's busy doing her things, talking to my dad. My dad's, you know, I mean, just resting. I feel like, I mean, they're not present. So there's not much communication between us.
Was there ever a time that you maybe felt that there was some good times that was going on?
Probably in the summer when my parents and I would go to the beach and hang out. I like those moments when we're out together. But recently, I feel like, you know, they're not there for me.
It sounds like maybe there was just some, you were feeling a lot better when y'all were all together as a family. And then maybe when your dad left for the service, it feels like maybe there was a disconnect there. You didn't have anyone to go to, so you went to your friends, it sounds like.
Yes, because I sometimes miss my dad, and I wanted him to come back earlier, but I know he was at work. But I mean, I feel lonely, and my mom was, you know, doing her other things, busy. So I feel like, you know, she wasn't paying attention to me. And then I found my friends, and they support me. They talk to me. They understand me.
Now, Belle, how are you doing today? How are you feeling?
I'm okay.
Now, from the notes, it's been saying that you've been just kind of staying to yourself at home. You haven't been really engaging with your siblings or your mother or your father.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, you don't have to talk. You're not forced to talk right now. So once we go through these sessions more, if you feel like you want to share anything, then you can share, okay?
I just feel sometimes my mom pays more attention to the older one, to my older brother, because he gets in more trouble. So I just feel like I'm in the way, so I just stay quiet, basically.
Well, I can tell you that you don't have to think that you're alone in that. I can relate. You're a middle child. I was a middle child as well, and there was times where I felt, you know, alone sometimes, but let me just reassure you that you're not, okay? And then Miss Luna, how are you this morning, Miss Luna?
Hi, I'm good.
How are you doing in school?
I am doing good.
Okay. So from what I'm hearing, you're the cheerleader of the family, huh?
Yes. Chatterbox.
Okay. So now, Miss Luna, how do you feel about your parents? Like, when your dad leaves?
happy. It is a little different. When dad's away, I do get sad and I try to help mom around the house. But I do feel like she is kind of a little preoccupied just with things going on when dad's not around. But when he comes back, I get excited, hoping that we can do things together, like how my older brother mentioned going to the beach. But I feel like that kind of doesn't always happen. But I'm hoping with this that we can start doing that more often, because I'll be excited to get everybody back.
Good, good. So Sally, what I'd like for you to do this time is I want you to let Steve know what are kind of some of the things that you want him to help you with.
Well, first of all, I would probably say, just like the kids are mentioning, we need a break specifically. That will probably do wonders, because, you know, just like the kids are telling you that they feel like there's no time. We have no time, zero time. We don't get to do family things together. Maybe we can incorporate, like, let's say, let's go to the beach together, or let's go camping together, you know, do something as a family. I think that will relieve some stress for him, for me, and for the kids.
Right, Steve, you just heard Sally talk about trying to get some time together. How does that make you feel? Is that something you feel like you can do?
I mean, absolutely. I want to do whatever I can to make this family work, but I need a break too. I mean, when do I get to break, have a moment to myself? It's just chaos at work, chaos at home. It's nonstop.
Well, a trip definitely to the beach should give you rest, you know, rest and recuperation. It'd be something fun.
Maybe you'd like that, but I don't like that.
So it looks like we just need to maybe find some middle ground, okay? We'll get there. Okay. Luis, what is it that, if you can tell your parents anything right now about how you want the relationship to get better with them, what would you tell them? What do you want them to know?
I just want to know that I love them, that I want to communicate more and to be there for us and to not fight no more, and that I just want a happy home.
Now, what would make you happy, Luis?
Spending time more with myself and my sisters, and just having a dinner, going out to the park, helping me with my schoolwork, so I could keep going to school, and just being there for me when I need them.
And I know you mentioned your sisters. This is the first time I hear you mention them. How do you feel about your sisters?
I have a good relationship with them. I don't really see them that much because I'm not much at home. I just feel that, you know, they probably feel the same as me, that my parents are not there for us, and that we just need more time from them.
And Ms. Bell, what would you like your parents to know about how you're feeling right now?
Just that I feel weird whenever dad gets home, because everybody seems stressed out trying to go around his feelings. So I guess just take in mind our feelings and figure out like how we can be a family again without all the stress.
And what would you like your siblings to know?
For them to check on me every once in a while, I guess. I know I keep to myself, but that doesn't mean like I don't want to talk. I just keep to myself because I feel like I'll be in the way, like I said earlier. But I still love them.
That's good to hear, definitely. Are there kind of any hobbies that the three of y'all do together, or something that would like build y'all's relationship up?
I guess what Luis said, to go to a park or something. I don't know. Amusement park.
SeaWorld.
SeaWorld.
So Luna, what would you like to tell your parents right now about how you're feeling about being here, and what would you want to tell them?
I feel a little hopeful and that I love them. And I think like one of my friends had mentioned what his parents do. I feel like dad needs to take just a dad day. Mom needs to take a mom day and leave us with the baby, the neighbor, so that they can have their alone time and then come back and we all do something together so that they can have that time.
And you seem pretty excited about wanting to go to the park with your siblings. So That's yeah. something you look forward to?
I would, because I know everyone is a little, I try to like interact, but then it's like sometimes I feel like I don't want to overstep because one is in their world and then one's with their friends. So I try to, but then I don't want to be that nagging little sister that's just poking at them the whole time.
Okay. All right. Now, Sally, hearing your kids just now, how does that make you feel?
Wow, very helpful. And I'm glad that they're at least sharing their, you know, their likes and dislikes. I like the idea that Luna is expressing about having a mom's day and a dad's day. I think that would be helpful. I also think about what Luis says about, you know, having a dinner together, like maybe, you know, when dad comes from deployments that we can plan out to have a real nice dinner, you know what I mean? And we can sit as a family. I think that will be helpful. And the SeaWorld idea to go to the amusement park, we actually get discounts for the tickets through the ITR office. So I think that's something doable, you know, and it will give us, you know, time together, and dad will have his dad day, you know, and he can just do nothing if he wants to, I don't know, go to the spa or something. Mm-hmm. I'll probably go get my nails done, I don't know, or my haircut or color.
Yeah.
You know, a me day will be great, a dad day will be awesome too, I think. I think the kids got very good ideas.
Okay, cool.
I now, just Steve, wish I would have asked them before.
Okay, and that's why we're here. Sometimes it takes these kind of events to bring us together to talk, and that's what we're going to hope to happen, okay? Now, Steve, hearing your kids, hearing your wife right now, have maybe things changed a little bit in your mind the past few minutes?
Yeah, I mean, of course. I want to be a better dad. I want to be a better husband. I know whatever I'm doing right now isn't working, because I know how it was with me growing up not having a dad around. I can see the same thing happening with my son right now. So it's not something that I want to continue, but you know, I don't know how to do it. And I think that's why Luna, my favorite, came up with the best idea, which I didn't even think about that. Having a separate day just to decompress and unwind.
Yeah. Okay. All right. So as we wrap up, we definitely want to keep building on this as in weeks to come. But before we leave today, we're going to go around. And I want you to say something positive about one other person, okay? Or each other. I have many positives you want to name. So Sally, let's start with you. Say something positive about Steve.
Well, I love him. And, you know, I think that he's a great dad. He doesn't need to try to be a great dad. He is already a great dad. And like I said, we just got to work things out and do a little bit more communicating. But I love him.
Okay. Steve?
About Sally, you want me to say it? Or
or whoever.
I guess I'll say it about Sally. She's been with me the whole time. So I can't really... I have to give her more credit than I give her, because she set this up, and without us coming to see you, Dr. Sorry, I've never seen your last
name. That's fine. You can just call me Roger. That's fine.
Okay, Dr. Roger, and set this up to get us maybe started on the right direction, because we've been off for a while. So I want to thank her for doing that.
Okay. Luis. Why don't you say something positive about someone in this room?
About my mom. Thank you for being so energetic and always looking out for us, for my sisters, protecting them, and actually be looking for myself and be worrying about what I'm doing with my friends. I know you're doing your best, and it's all for my well-being. Thank you for that.
Okay.
You're welcome.
All right, Belle.
I guess Luna, I know that she tries to be a good spirit, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. So thank you for being happy, I guess.
All right. Good, good, good. All right, Miss Luna, I want you to say something positive about someone or all of them.
Okay. Well, first, Mom, thank you for putting this together and helping us come back together, and Dad for being open to wanting this. I'm excited. Hopefully SeaWorld is in my future right now. And then my sister, for always being there before she went a little quiet because everything going on, but I'm ready to get that fun, exciting person back. And then my older brother, who is awesome. So I'm hoping that we can all just be together. And for yourself, Rogelio, for being here with us and helping us out.
Awesome. Okay. So let's build on this for next week, guys, okay? I look forward to seeing y'all back here in the office. Keep positive, keep hopeful, and I'll see y'all next week, okay?
Alrighty. Thank you so much,
sir. Thank you.
Alrighty. Bye.